My name is Paul Voge. This is my third year on staff at Camp Brookwoods and Deer Run. Well, I've only been on staff at Camp Brookwoods, actually. I'm hoping one day to get hired by Deer Run, but that is still up in the air. I like scuba diving. My favorite food is donuts. I love the New York Mets. I'm the youngest of five. And if I could have a lake house or a ski house, I'd go for a lake house. Thunderball is a game that we play up in the Thunderball courts. They look a lot like tennis courts, but they're better. Now, the Thunderball courts, about once a week, every kid will play Thunderball. The reason we have that is that we want to be able to judge the kids' maturity, their character, and more than that, their heart. And Thunderball judges heart more than any game I know. Now, Thunderball is a game played with Thunderballs. They look a little bit like kickballs. And you throw the kickballs at each other, and it's encouraged that you throw it as hard as you can. Now, a lot of people like to say that Thunderball reminds them of dodgeball. It is not like dodgeball at all. In fact, we use dodgeball to help us explain the rules, because then they'll know exactly what it's not like, because it's Thunderball. In 1944, the camp was started by the Andreessen family, and the Andreessen family created Thunderball because they wanted to be able to judge young men's character, their heart, their determination, more than that, their mental strength. It's a physical game, no doubt. The stronger kids will be better players, but the mentally strong kids will be better at playing the game. The reason I love Thunderball is because, first of all, it gets a little sweat going. That's good, get the heart pumping. But more than that, I think that's what separates the boys into the men and the men from the wolves. So 1944, Thunderball is created. Since then, every boy that has come through Brookwoods camp, this is huge, in the last 71 years has played Thunderball, whether they wanted to or not. We didn't force them, but we did ask them to choose their own challenge, and then we highly encouraged them to choose yes. Now, there are some legends in the Thunderball world. Kirk Schweitzer, Ben Dunning, two of the best Thunderball players I know. Kirk Schweitzer was one of the best jail guards I've ever seen. Peter Snedeker, that guy could throw a ball faster than you'd like if you were on the other team. Now, as a kid, I struggled with reaching the jail. One of these years, I realized that the best way is to just sort of dislocate your shoulder. You just let your shoulder pop right out and use it like a whip. Throw it over the fence every time. Now, ever since I've been dislocating my shoulder, I'd like to think I'm pretty good at throwing to the jail, and that's sort of my strength. Some people play a lot of defense, some people play a lot of offense, some people guard the jail. I like to throw to the jail. Thunderball is especially played when you can hear the thunder. At flag lowering, Mark or myself will say something like, "Can you hear the thunder?" And they'll know we're talking about Thunderball. It's a metaphor. There's no thunder. We wouldn't play thunder. Well, not at this game. Jesus.